I'm gonna press F5, run the game. So I have the basic things working for my new C++ fighting game, or I should say it's going to be a fighting game. Right now I only have the basic stuff, the moving, the animations, punching. I also have the collisions and the other player reacting to the collision. Okay, this is a 1v1 game. I can control both of the players. And I have the camera movement. This is from my last video, Devlog number 0. Even though I only have the basic stuff, I'm obviously going to build more stuff, more details on top of this. I'm going to have the stuff like everything, but for example, I might have the little details like the split second pause or the split second slow motion upon the immediate impact. I'm not sure what that is called. Slow motion, basically. I might also have some visual effects, the player shaking or the camera shake, you know, the typical Street Fighter 2 stuff. And it's the details that give you the feeling of actually hitting something, or in this case, hitting somebody. Right now, I'm just focused on the core game mechanics, which are things like the collision. And in this video, I'm going to talk about this little editor that I have, a custom editor for the colliders. As you can see, I have the colliders for each of the body parts, starting from the head, goes all the way down to right elbow, right hand, left foot, all the way down to the right foot, from head to toe basically, and I can edit them, change their position, rotate them, make them bigger or make them smaller. And if I save, click on save, press F11 to go back to the fight scene, and you can see, I'm gonna slow down the game. Okay, you can see the collider that I just edited, which is huge now, the right foot, or is that the left foot? I can also access every other animations. In this case, it's the jab. And you can see I've only edited the very few important collider parts. This is just the very beginning of my development for this new game. As you can see, I can also zoom in here. I have these two colliders for the jab. But for the rest of the animation, you can see that the colliders don't exactly match. But again, the details will be ironed out as I work more and more on this project. Let me see if I can access the folder, if I can find it. The source folder. Okay, so here are the collider files, .collider. This is just some custom file that I made up. If I open this in Notepad, you can see that this is nothing more than an entire array of integers and some float values. These just represent each of the colliders in order. So for example, for the idle, the array of idle colliders, I have every data for each of the colliders, the rotations, each of the 4 points. These are all box colliders, and box colliders are pretty easy when it comes to collision detection, as well as basic convex collision detection. They're not very difficult to implement, so everything is convex in my game in terms of the collision. So I have all the basic info, starting from the head to the toe, the center positions, the 4 points of a quad, as well as the rotation. And then when I go into the fight scene, I load those data, and there you see it in action. Okay, if I punch, you can see the yellow and the red lines going from the player position to, I'm gonna slow this down. Okay, the yellow lines represent each of the 4 corners. The red line represents the center. Obviously, these things are not going to be shown in the actual game. This is just for me, for development purposes, but they let me know that I'm on for a collision in a single frame, for example. It lets me know that I'm getting the exact position that should make sense. Okay, obviously for a punch, you don't want the collision detection too early or too late. You want it at the right moment. And when you hit it, let me see if I can hit the, if I can time it right. Looks like right now I'm only getting detection from the head, but if I had the correct code, actually this should be, we should have some sort of reaction to the giant collider that I'm hitting right now. I just don't have that code right now. I'm only detecting collision for the head. Kind of forgot about that. But anyways, the basic things are working pretty smoothly, pretty well, which allows me to build more stuff on top of that without worrying about things bugging out and so on. It's just like building a house. You don't see the foundation, but the foundations are important. And I guess that's pretty much it. That's everything I have right now at this point. Again, I'm gonna add more stuff on top of this, step by step. I'm gonna go slow. The next priority that I have is something like Hadouken, for example. Not sure if that's the right pronunciation. I'm gonna have Shorukens, Hadoukens, special moves basically. I need to get the entire list of the recent key presses. Right now the player is simply reacting to every single key, but you know, if you remember Street Fighter 2, you get the list of all your recent presses and then you decide whether you've done a special move or not, something like a Hadouken. So those things will be added. Hopefully as time goes, this will turn more and more into an actual video game. Okay, so that's it for this video. I'm gonna have more updates later on, and thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.